Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's look at using conditional formatting in Numbers. So I'm using Numbers version 3, and let's take a look at conditional highlighting, previously called conditional formatting. So I've got a simple table here, just an inventory. And say I want to have a cell highlighted when inventory drops too low in something as the weeks go on. So let's start just by selecting one cell, for instance. And we'll go to over here in the format bar. If you don't see it, turn on format and go over to cell and then go to conditional highlighting. And there are no rules here in conditional highlighting yet. I haven't set any for this document. So I'm going to click on add rule, and I have several different categories. I'm going to use the numbers category, which is probably the most common, and set it to basically be do something when the number is less than or equal to, let's say, 40. So, and I can set what I want it to do. It's going to be, in this case, a red fill. There's all sorts of different things I can do in here. I can choose custom style as well. Let's just stick with red. And I'm done. So now nothing happens because I've only put it in this one cell, which is 67. So there's no, that's not less than 40, so it's fine. I can select another cell here, hit conditional highlighting, and you can see that it doesn't have any there. This one, though, show highlighting rules, and I see the one. Okay, so what I can do to apply this to all is basically select this whole area, show highlighting rules, and now it's telling me that I've got, I can combine the highlighting rules. So all the highlighting rules used by all these different cells in here, which in this case, I know it's just this one that's in here. Or I can clear them if I want. So let's do combine, which will basically apply that one cell's rules to all of these cells. And now we can see here it worked. Every cell in here that's less than 40 is now highlighted in red. So while I've got all this selected, I can make changes here and say let's set it to 30 there, and let's do, instead of a red fill, let's do a custom style here, which then allows me to do all this stuff. I can make it bold and change its background color to something else. So there's a lot of different things you can do, and this is called rule one. And I could at this point hit the trash can button here and delete it. I can also add a second rule. So let's do that. If it's less than or equal to 10, then change to red. And now I've got two rules in place. And what I want to do is I want to assign which precedence I want. I'm going to drag this to the top and give this one precedence over this one. So that way I get red here for less than 10. And if it doesn't hit that rule, then it's going to go look at the other rules and it's going to set it to yellow here for less than 30. So conditional highlighting is purely a visual effect. You're going to see something in the table, but you're not going to perform any calculations with this. If I wanted to, say, find out the number of these cells that were less than 30, I would want to do a formula for that, not use conditional highlighting like this. And here's something cool you can do. You don't have to have hard-coded numbers here. I've typed in 10 and 30 for the conditional highlighting. I can actually pull the numbers from cells. So I've created another table here with those numbers in it. And I'm going to, instead of using hard-coded 10, I'm going to hit the formula button there and select that cell. And same thing here, hit that formula button there and select this cell. I can actually type in a full formula that does a calculation. But I'm just going to pull from these cells here. And now what I've got is 10 and 30 are still the triggers, but they are being pulled from this table. So if I change this to 40, you can see it automatically changes in the table there. It's not hidden inside of that. And this could actually be a calculation, or I could, for instance, pull this from, you know, some sort of thing like the average. Like, let's say, that could be the average inventory amount. So if something falls below the average, there's a lot you can do. A better way to do it might actually be to insert another header row here and call this the minimums for each of these. And then I could say, okay, well, if apples falls below 20, then give me an alert. This falls below 20. If these fall below 50, give me an alert. And then apply conditional formatting for just this column here and have it be triggered by this. So here I've actually done it for this first two columns. Let me show you how I do it for the third one. Select all this. Add rule is less than or equal to, hit the formula button, hit this minimum cell here, return, And now there we go. Each one is responding to its own set there from another header row. So I can change this to say 60, and you can see automatically updates for that one. Change this one to 10 and it updates. So a lot of different ways you can use conditional formatting.